Dear students, today we'll find area of a triangle and area of a parallelogram in terms of cross product. First come to find area of a triangle. Let us consider a triangle OPQ. The two sides OP and OQ are represented by A vector and B vector respectively. Let theta be the angle between them. Now you draw a perpendicular, that is QN, on OP. Area of the triangle, the formula you know, that is half into base into height. If you consider the base is OP, height is QN. For the base OP, height is QN. So area becomes half into OP into QN. From the figure, in triangle OQN, sin theta is equal to QN by OQ, because OQN is a right angle triangle. QN, what is OQ? OQ is your B. Or QN, you got B sin theta. So from equation one, area becomes half OP. OP is your A vector magnitude into A, and QN, that is B sin theta. So you got half AB sin theta. You know AB sin theta is magnitude of cross product of A vector and B vector. So area of the triangle, you got half of magnitude of cross product of two vectors representing the two sides of the triangle. So now come to area of a parallelogram. So let us consider a parallelogram. It is a parallelogram. That parallelogram, that is OP SQ, the two vectors represent two sides of the parallelogram, OP and OQ respectively. Let theta be the angle between the two vectors. Now you draw a perpendicular, let it be QN, on OP. Now OQN is a right angle triangle. So area of the parallelogram, you know, area of parallelogram, that equal to base into height. If you consider the base as OP, then height is QN. That equal to OP into QN. So in the figure, OP length, that is A vector magnitude A, OQ, that is B vector magnitude, that is B. So now in this triangle, that is right angle triangle OQN, we have to find what is QN. Sin theta is equal to QN by OQ, that is QN by B, or QN is equal to B sin theta. From equation 1, area in place of A, in place of OP you write A, that is A, in place of QN you write B sin theta, A into B sin theta, that is AP sin theta. AP sin theta, you know, it is the magnitude of cross product of A and B. So area you got, that is A vector cross B vector magnitude. So what is your conclusion? Area of a parallelogram is magnitude of cross product of two vectors representing the two adjacent sides of the parallelogram. So here generally we are considering area as a vector quantity. So area vector, you can say that is the cross product of the two vectors representing the two sides of the parallelogram. And magnitude of the area, that is magnitude of the cross product of the two vectors representing the two sides. Similarly, area vector in the triangle, that is the half of cross product of the two vectors representing the two sides of the triangle, and magnitude of the area, that is half of magnitude of cross product of two vectors representing the two sides of the triangle. Now, instead of two sides of the parallelogram, if the two diagonals are given, then what will be the area of the parallelogram? It is OPSQ. It is OS diagonal. It is QP diagonal. Let this diagonal is R1 vector and this diagonal is R2 vector. Let it is A vector, it is B vector. So now you know in a parallelogram the two diagonals, here R1 vector can be written as A vector cross B vector. You apply parallelogram of vector addition, this diagonal representing the resultant of A vector and B vector. Similarly, you apply triangle law to this triangle OQP, then A is the resultant of B and R2, so you can write A vector, your B vector plus R2, or R2 vector is equal to A vector minus B vector. So you remember, in a parallelogram, the two diagonals represents A vector plus B vector and A vector minus B vector, where A vector and B vector represent the two sides, adjacent sides of the parallelogram. Now, R1 vector cross R2 vector, that is A vector plus B vector cross A vector minus B vector, that equals to A vector cross A vector plus A vector cross A vector, then minus A vector cross B vector, then plus B vector cross A vector, then minus B vector cross B vector. You know, cross product of equal vectors is null vector. So it is 0 vector minus A cross B, then minus A cross B, because B cross A is equal to minus A cross B, that is their cross product is anti-commutative, then minus 0 vector. So you got here minus 2 A vector cross B vector, or I can say here A vector cross B vector magnitude is equal to half of R1 vector cross R2 vector magnitude. therefore area of parallelogram that is a vector cross b vector magnitude that equal to half of r1 vector cross r2 vector magnitude. So you got area of the parallelogram is half of magnitude of cross product of two vectors representing the two diagonals of the parallelogram.